the best note-taking workflows can actually help you think better. That's why every week going forward, we're going to release a new note-taking workflow that's specifically designed to improve your thinking. These are going to be a little bit different than the videos that we launched. I'm going to go into the first two that you see here, a daily reflection and building a personal CRM in your notes. But the idea is that we're going to teach you the entire workflow from start to finish in very simple to understand terms using GIFs right in an email so that you don't have to watch any video, you don't have to read any article, any of that stuff. So if you want these workflows, you can go to reflectnotes.beehive.com and subscribe. I'll also put the link in the description of this video. But to kick us off, I'm going to cover the first two here. So let me start off with the daily reflection. This is one of the things that's been the most important to me in terms of my note-taking journey. And I think it's what actually got me really addicted to taking notes. It became a therapeutic exercise that I did every morning. And so in this workflow, I walk through exactly how to set this up in your notes and how to do it every morning. And I also cover some mental benefits that it gives you. So the first step is setting it up as an actual template in your notes. And I think this is important because when you wake up in the morning and you open your notes, you want to just get right in there and start note-taking. You don't want to have to write out some template. You don't want to have to think about what you're going to do. You just want to start taking notes. So the easiest way to do that is to set it up as a basic template. And you can choose whatever daily reflection you want. I actually recommend going into ChatGPT or Cloud or something and crafting a daily reflection around what you want to accomplish. Maybe you want to start off your day more relaxed. Maybe you want to be more productive. Maybe you just want some mental calm. All that stuff can be accomplished with just a few minutes each morning with a daily reflection. So I will also include a link to my templates spreadsheet. So if you want, you can just copy the template that I use, but I do recommend customizing it for yourself. Once you've got the template built, you can just pull it up in your notes every morning that you see here. And you do that just using a slash and pulling up the title of your template. And then you can just go in and fill it in as you go. It's very, very simple. And even if you still want to type it, I think this is the exercise that just lets you sit down in a few minutes and actually record it. But I should say, I don't ever type mine anymore. I always transcribe mine now. I think that is the easiest thing to do. So what you can do is, well, obviously you can take a voice note, but that's just going to leave you with a big block of text. So what I recommend doing is then going in and taking your template and adding it to a custom AI prompt, which will then let you organize it. And, you know, we've got a bunch of videos on our custom AI assistant if you've never done that before, but it's super, super easy. And so if you want, you can copy both the template and the AI prompt that I use from the spreadsheet that we link to in this workflow. But that's pretty much it. You go in, set up your template each day, record your daily reflection, and then organize it using AI. And actually, two of those steps are optional. You can just do the base template if you want to. So this is our first workflow, and you'll see here at the bottom that if you want to dive into it in more detail, you can go watch the full YouTube video, which you might have even seen already. And again, you can copy all of the templates and AI prompts. So this is kind of the point of sharing a workflow, is that we're going to communicate it in very simple and easy to understand terms in the email so that you can digest it very quickly and start doing it. And if you have more questions, you can go in and watch the video in more detail. You can also respond to the emails, and I'll just respond to your questions you have. So if you ever have a question on a note-taking workflow, I'll answer it directly. All right, and then the second one I actually just published this morning here. So this is a building a personal CRM in your notes. Now, this is something that I had never had before, and Reflect gave me for the first time, and it's been truly magical ever since then, especially as I've done lots of sales calls, I've met lots of people for partnerships. I both do my work on Reflect, and I have a side agency, so this has been absolutely critical for me staying organized and keeping all the people I meet together. It actually makes me wish that I had had this in university and stuff too, when I was just rapidly meeting people so frequently. I wish I had captured all of that and been able to sort of track what people are doing, not just for networking, but to build better relationships and keep better in touch with people. So let me kind of show you how we typically build our personal CRMs in Reflect. And I should note that I copied this workflow from Alex, our CEO, who originally built it. And I think this is one of the core principle or core functionalities that he built Reflect for. So the first step is going to be capturing the contacts in your notes. That's the most important part. And zooming out a little bit, I think this is the most important part of using a daily note format, is that every day you have the daily note that you see here in the GIF. And it can just act as your scratch pad. You can add anything to it. And that means you never have to sit there and worry about where something should go. It should always go in your daily note if you don't have a specific place for it. So that's the important thing. But if you're at a party or at an event, or even if you have back-to-back meetings or something like that, it can be kind of cumbersome to sit there and type out a new contact. Even if you have access to it on your phone, which Reflex does, you don't want to sit there after meeting someone and just type in a contact. So what I do is, again, I record an audio note. You'll notice there's a theme here. I use audio notes a lot, and I actually have my action button on my iPhone 15 set up to start transcribing a voice note whenever I push the button. If you don't have the iPhone 15, you can also set up a widget. That's the dot that you see there underneath my clock. And that will do the same thing. It'll start recording. What that allows me to do is the second after I meet someone, could be a random person in a coffee shop, it could be someone at an event I'm at, whatever, I can just quickly record a quick voice note. I like to record who I met with, what I did, and just some vague context. So in the example down there below, I met Annalyn Taneva, who actually I'd met many times before, but I just use her name as an example. And she runs an affiliate marketing agency. So maybe I was planning on working with her agency, and I would say I met Annalyn Taneva about her affiliate marketing agency, and we talked about yada yada. You can include whatever context you want. But the important part is that once you take that audio note, it is captured within your daily note, and you no longer have to worry about it. Step two is going in and adding any additional information and context. So again, right after you meet a person, even if you're recording a voice note, you probably don't want to sit there and just ramble about the person and everything you know. But you can go in and add that later. So what I typically do is I'll go back in, which you'll see in this GIF here. I'll take the person's name. I will add a backlink. I will then pull up the person template, which is pre-built in Reflect. But you know, you could build whatever template you want and add whatever criteria you want. And then I just go in and fill in the information, which again was captured from the voice note. I'm just kind of putting it in here. If you wanted to, you could actually set up a custom AI prompt that will organize it for you. So I think that's going to be my next step. I might do a follow-up. But the important part is that the information's there, and then you can organize it whenever you want. And even if you forget to organize it, the information's still captured. So I could forget to add a backlink note for this person, Annalyn, and if I search my notes for Annalyn or her agency, I'll still be able to find it. All right, step three, make a backlinked entry each time you meet the person again. Okay, so we've met the person, and let's say, I'll continue with this example. Let's say I'm working with Annalyn and her agency, Agency Vivian, on affiliate marketing, and then we have a follow-up next week. So then I'm going to actually create a note, and I'm going to say that I met with her on this date at this time. And underneath that bullet point, I can put anything that I need to do. In this case, it is signing a contract. So, if I have an action item that I need to sign a contract with Annalyn, I can backlink her name. If I want to, I can backlink to her agency. And then that connects everything together. I now have that task, so I know that I need to complete it, but I know who it's connected to. I know the day that it happened on. I know the company of the person who it's connected to. And I can see all of this down below in that incoming backlink section in the GIF. So again, I know this is a little weird walkthrough on a video, but this is just to highlight what the emails will look like. The GIFs are so that you don't have to ever leave the email. You can do it all in email. Then last step four here, I go into easily logging these meeting notes. If you want to, you don't have to do any of this manually. You can just use the calendar integration. And that allows you to just click on a calendar invite, and it will automatically add the meeting to your note. So here's a different example. It's Barbara for a content sync. So I can imagine if maybe I'm running a content team or something, and this is a weekly sync that I have. I can just, again, click on that. It pulls up the meeting box, and then I can quickly and easily add it to my notes. The nice thing about this is that it backlinks the contact for me, so I don't have to do any of that manually. It also backlinks, creates a custom backlink for the meeting itself, which I've asked it to do. That's totally optional, but this is just something that kind of easily takes the steps out. And again, if you want a full video walkthrough on the process with some more detailed tips, you can watch the actual YouTube video on it. And if you need help with the AI assistant, I include links to that too. So that's pretty much it. If you want more of these workflows, you can, again, get these in your inbox every Monday, once a week. I will be publishing them. And the whole thing will be done from the email. You don't have to watch the video if you want to, but I will always include a link. to more information if you want to dive in more depth.